Now, after months of intense investigation, Samsung Electronics has finally revealed the cause of the fires in some of its Galaxy Note 7s. The president of Samsung's mobile division shared the details himself at a press conference in Seoul and once again expressed sorrow for the incident. Our Kim Min-ji, who is at the press conference, joins us on the phone for details. So, Min-ji, these fires prompted Samsung to order an unprecedented global recall. And finally, now we know the root of the problem.
Mark, Samsung Electronics concluded that batteries were the cause of the Galaxy Note 7's catching fire and not the internal structure of the model or software. The tech giant says tests were carried out on both batteries, ones used in the initial models and the second ones used in the replacement phone. In battery A, it was attributed to design flaws. This, in some cases, allowed positive and negative electrodes to meet, igniting a fire. In battery B, which came from a different supplier, there were welding problems which led to short circuit and caused the copper to melt. Samsung also called in global companies, including Underwriters Laboratories, to conduct investigations of their own, all of which announced similar findings. Samsung says it conducted tests on 200,000 devices and 30,000 batteries, which involved the charging and discharging processes to simulate what happened in the most similar conditions. The investigation examined all aspects of the Galaxy Note 7, including its hardware and software and related processes, such as assembly, quality assurance testing, and logistics. Now, Samsung said although the cause was a battery defect, they are responsible, as they said, the battery specifications, and they were not able to catch the problem in advance.
Yes, so this confirmed what many people had been thinking all along, really, that it probably had something to do with the battery. But Min-ji, Samsung has also announced measures to prevent something similar happening again.
Yes, that's right. In fact, it's seen as crucial with the company set to release its flagship Galaxy S8 sometime this year. And based on the investigation, Samsung says it has implemented a broad range of internal quality and safety processes to further enhance product safety. It has also formed a battery advisory group of external advisors, academic and research experts to ensure it maintains a clear and objective perspective on battery safety and innovation. Samsung stressed that they will put safety first from start to finish, adding they have learned a lesson from the Note 7 debacle. Back to you, Mark.